Are you ready, Dr. Neutron?
Yes, Professor Proton.
To the lab!
Hello. Unfortunately, Professor Proton was kidnapped last night by Michael Jackson.
You're on.
Before performing both of these labs, make sure you have the proper safety equipment, including these goggles. And this lab coat.
So we'll just have to start without him. Hopefully he's okay. There are several ways to measure density. One way is a density column.
Density is the mass in a unit volume of any substance.
You can create a density column with any household liquid. Today we will be using the following.
A clear glass container, citric acid, milk, cooking oil, and distilled water. Yes,
it's in. Density equals mass over volume.
What?
It is expressed in grams per milliliter or pounds per cubic foot.
It is determined to find the concentration of a substance.
Yeah, yeah.
Gases are difficult to measure because they have very low densities.
Okay.
Okay. To create the density column, we will pour the following liquid into the beaker here. And we will start with citric acid, which has a density of 1.66. Next, we will put milk battery. Milk has a density of 1.02, by the way. Third, we will put water, which has a density of 1. Okay. We will finish off with cooking oil, which has a density of 0.92. Voila. We will return in 5 minutes to give it time so we could separate. Okay, 5 minutes later, the liquids have clearly separated. Right here is citric acid, which is the most dense. And then we have the milk right here, which is at second highest density. The water and the cooking oil with the least density. So yeah, that concludes this example for density. Hey look, Garrett's back. At our next lab, we will be making a chemical reaction with an acid and a base.
An acid has a sour taste and has hydrogen ions.
A base feels slippery and has hydroxide ions.
When an acid and base combine, it creates a chemical reaction.
Baking soda is a base, and vinegar is an acid.
The materials we will be using are baking soda, a medium-sized bowl, and vinegar. And that's it.
In the first step of this lab, you are going to want to pour half a pint of baking soda into the bowl, like you can see here, as we have plainly done. Then you want to pour 1 cup of vinegar, here's the cup, into the solution. But be careful, because it is going to literally explode.
When baking soda and vinegar combines, it creates carbon dioxide.
So after you pour the baking soda in, then it's time to pour 1 cup of vinegar into the solution. Dr. Neutron, would you like to pour the cup of vinegar in? Screw the cup. Dr. Neutron, what are you doing? Dr. Neutron! Yeah. See, kids, you don't want to act like Dr. Neutron here. You don't want to act like Dr. Neutron here. He sleeps in class, kids. Okay, kids, now let's do it the right way. Take the cup full of vinegar, gently pour it into the bowl, like so. No, Dr. Neutron. Look at that. We have a chemical reaction as it emits gas.
A chemical reaction is a process in which atoms rearrange themselves into a new substance. This is also an exothermic reaction.
And thank you for joining us!
Party.
Yes.
Stay classy, San Diego.
And this is why they call Garrett a pothead. That's a great way to start off the show. Would you like to give it a shot? Dr. Neutron. Would you like a half a pint or 1 full pint? Guess who's back. So we'll just have to start without him. Crap. To create a density column, pour all beaker. We will start with citric acid, which has a density of 1.66.
A bug. Look at that. Look at that. Pincher bug. Swim, little pinchy swim.
Okay, you're done.
All the gathered liquids into the beaker. Hopefully one that does not have a bug in it. So we will start with citric acid, which has a density of 1.66. Oh. What? Alright. Okay. To create the density column, we will put.
We're never gonna get this.
Man down, man down. Good night. 1.02. Oh god, that's still good. Oh, I'm having visual problems.
You're going.